So Canva's autofocus feature to create that blurry background, otherwise known as bokeh, it's actually really impressive. And I know I talked about it before, but I want to show you a few things why I think that is. So here we are in Canva, and I'm going to pick a picture of this dog. And as you can see, the background probably could use a bit more blur to it. Now, what makes this super impressive is that, let's say a program like Luminar AI that has portrait bokeh AI, it works very well. However, it's only for portraits. It's only for humans. It doesn't work on animals at all. So this is a big plus for Canva being able to do it with your pets. Now we're going to go ahead into the autofocus function here. Now, if you don't see it, you just have to scroll all the way to the bottom and it is there. I'll move myself here. There you go. Right under tools. And by default, the slider's at 50%, which makes it look very good. There's a little bit of foreground blur here, which looks great. And it really smoothens out that background. Does a really good job of it. Let's try it on a group photo. Now, what I've noticed about the group photos is if I grab a picture like this, it tends to work well with subjects that are fairly close to the middle. So I'm going to bring the intensity down to 20 here. Let's zoom in a bit there or zoom out. And you see it does a fairly decent job. There's a bit of haloing here, hardly noticeable. But compared to the original, that really makes the subjects pop out of the image even more. Again, very impressive. However, you're going to see in this example, it doesn't work too well for bigger groups. So as we saw in the previous example, there was only like 4 people in that image. Now we have 6 people. And it does an okay job. The face here is blurry, and if I were to adjust the positioning there, that's a lot better. But other than a slight haloing here that unfortunately can't be fixed within Canva, you're kind of pushing it with bigger groups. I would say at the most 3 to 4 people, and when it comes to group photos, ideally you'd want them to be in the center of the image. Now in this example, I wanted to see how it would work with an object. So we're going to go ahead and click the autofocus feature. And as you can see, it blurs out the backgrounds a bit much. So we're going to bring it down to, let's say 30. In this particular case, it works very well. It really looks like that, you know, 1.2, 1.4 aperture. Now again, I do want to show you one more example where it's not perfect. It may not work for everything. So I'm going to try it with this image here. Bring the intensity down to about 20. And it actually does a pretty decent job with this image here. But as I said before, you could see a little bit of haloing there, but not too much, not too noticeable. But so far, I'm really impressed how this works, especially that it can work with objects and pets. You're not limited to people. Now, in case you're wondering about the other new features within Canva, I did cover that in this video, so be sure to check that out. For now, get out there, hit record, create, and I'll see you when I see you.